I'm gonna bring him in. He's man enough to pull up. So I'm gonna talk to the nigga that I had respect for that let the trolls cause this distinction. And let's see if we can fix this shit. Because I totally support the brother, man.
I was wondering about y'all history because I'm new here and I don't
know. Our history is YouTube. I shouted the nigga out. I seen this shit. Niggas was hating on him. I mean, I can bring him in if you want to commentate. You know what I mean? If you want to be a part of it, I can bring him in a minute.
Yeah.
But the history of me and him is, okay, that's cool. So the history of me and him is I stumbled up on him as you on YouTube because I've been breeding dogs since I was in my early 20s. I'm about to be 44 Thursday. I just stumbled up on him and multiple other YouTubers and I shouted the brother out. He didn't need my fucking shout out. He acknowledged that. I didn't know that the trolls was following every comment that I post on people's channel outside of this shit. So I salute the brother out. The brother give me a shout out on his channel. The trolls follow me however the fuck they doing this shit on the internet. So they start trolling him and he then blamed it on me. Just give me a second to get some pen and paper and I'll let you speak.
My nigga, the beginning, yeah, it started off with that. The beginning, yeah, it did. In the beginning, we was rapping. You know what I'm saying? When you ain't have my number no more, you start talking about that shit on the internet. That's point blank curse. And from that point on,
hold up. Still up, bro. I never disrespected you, and you sitting up here insinuating that I did. You sitting up here insinuating like I was working with the trolls, my nigga, and that's bullshit. I ain't done nothing but gave you straight props, man. Real man shit. You take care of your family, you breed your dogs, you do what the fuck you gotta do, papers or no papers, and still fucking get it. Nigga, you ain't addressing none of my lives, giving you straight props. I ain't disrespected you to you. I felt you disrespected me. You didn't disrespect me off of nothing you directly heard from my mouth. You disrespected me off of shit some trolls told you, bro. You just sit up here and admitted this shit. You didn't even go to my live streams and see what I even said to then respond to exactly what I said. You just admitted this shit earlier in my life. This shit on record and I don't take my shit down.
Bro, this shit started with the fucking phone number, bro. I changed my number and you wasn't a nigga in my brain to immediately get a number to. Outside of this YouTube shit, nigga, I do got a real life. I do got family, friends that come before anybody in the YouTube world. So I didn't get you the number in a manageable time or in a time you felt cool, you spoke on it. Which didn't make no sense. I didn't understand. It's my nigga, I don't know you. No other nigga had nothing to say about not having Weezy number. You the only one. And it confused the shit out of me.
But my nigga, I'm telling you from the heart what the fuck it is. And you sitting up here trying to do this gangster shit on my shit, bro. Now, if trolls follow me to try to destroy your relationship that potentially was in the air between you and I, it's been just cool niggas who chop it up with each other. I can turn on my live right now, and I can show you shirts that I made for you and told you I don't want your real address. I made for you and your wife. I got shirts here I can't sell to nobody else that I was giving to you. You refused to take them. I made shirts. You think I'm mine? I'm going to get them right now and turn on my camera.
You did one thing that I did not respect. I respect the fact that you gave me a shout out. I didn't respect the fact that you got upset that you ain't have my number no more.
Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question. Did my number change from the day I gave it to you myself?
My nigga, I don't know, my nigga, because I don't have my that same phone number.
So you had my number. You didn't need to ask them for my number because you always had my number.
I just said I don't know if your number changed.
Right, bro. Because you wasn't infatuated with me. You wasn't on no bitch shit. So therefore, you wasn't a groupie. So you got my number. If it ain't programmed in your phone, you don't remember it.
Stop telling me you going to let me speak if you're not going to let me speak.
Honestly, you got the mic. When you done, let me know. But I ain't gonna, if you disrespect me, bro, I'ma shut. And I'm not gonna interrupt you when you're done.
I'm able to speak. This shit low as a motherfucker. I turn the volume up on this bitch.
I tell you what, get that fixed, man. You come back, right? Because like, you can't ask me how to do what you doing in Baltimore, and I'm in Indianapolis. Like, we like this place. Oh no, hold up, bro. Right, hold up. Let me correct.
We're gonna do it the way you said.
Hold up for a second. It ain't the way
you said.
Hold up for a second. I'm gonna stand by my. Hold up for a second. Listen, bro. You're right.
Living with a woman, but sleeping on a couch.
There wasn't me no animosity against you, bro. Number one, I didn't say nothing negative to you or about you. Hold up, bro. I didn't come at the nigga. I saluted the nigga. I didn't even do it publicly. I've done it in his chat. You and I had private phone conversations about this shit, bruh. You talking, but nobody hears you. I'm talking right now.
Okay, I'm in movie
mode. Yeah. I understand. Look, I promise. I understand.
Y'all know goddamn well.
I promise you I understand.
I've been doing this shit over 6 months.